Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. Thousands of Britons took advantage of the hot weather today by flocking to beaches ahead of another week-long scorcher, which will see temperatures rise to 32°C. Bookies have even slashed the odds on Britain experiencing its hottest day ever next week to just 2/1, with the current highest temperature recorded being 38.5°C in Brogdale, near Faversham, Kent, in 2003. The predictions means there will be no relief for experts who issued a warning across the UK about sunburns after hundreds were hospitalised as Britain struggles to cope with a heatwave. Yuck. A competitor at the Whitstable Oyster Festival grimaces during today's contest to celebrate the Kent seaside town's oyster trade. In it to win it, oyster-eating competitors knock back the mollusks in the sunshine today in Whitstable, southeast England head-to-head. Contestants at the Whitstable oyster-eating competition race to down half a dozen oysters and half a pint beer focused. Up to 36 people take part in the oyster-eating competition every year in Whitstable. Above, contestants hunch over the table while stuffing their mouths with the shellfish winner. Oyster-eating enthusiasts stuff their faces with the oysters and neck pints of beer during the messy annual contest. Here come the shellfish. Buckets full of oysters are carried to shore for the festival in Whitstable to celebrate the town's trade as scorching rays beat down in Kent. Residents of Whitstable made their way to the harbour for their annual oyster-eating competition to celebrate the seaside town's oyster trade. Meanwhile, Londoners enjoyed the UK's largest inflatable water slide in Brockwell Park during Lambeth Country Show. People are encouraged to use common sense when enjoying the sun and protect themselves from damaging UV rays, Public Health England has urged. The warning comes after 220 people were admitted to hospitals in Northern Ireland over the past 2 months for sunburn treatment. There are now concerns that more could be hospitalised across the United Kingdom in order to treat sunburn as the hot weather continues. Festival goers slide down Vita Coco's slip and slide during Lambeth Country Show at Brockwell Park, South London. Today, Lambeth Country Show hosted the UK's largest inflatable water slide today. Thrill seekers slid down the slippery slide in South London. Scorching sun, festival goers at the Lambeth Country Show enjoy the Vita Coco water slide in the sunshine, no hands. Lambeth Country Show attendees took advantage of the UK's largest inflatable water slide in South London today. I'm soaked. Festival goers slid down the enormous Vita Coco slide at Brockwell Park today. Some bravely wore their clothes rather than swimming costumes. Steep drop, daredevil festival goers shoot down the near vertical Vita Coco water slide at Lambeth Country Show today. Sunshine should return for the first weekend of the summer holidays after parts of Britain saw heavy showers on Friday evening. Yesterday, travel chaos occurred with traffic backed up for over an hour on the M25 as holidaymakers began to set off following the start of the school break. Next week could be the hottest yet this summer, with forecasters expecting highs of 95°F-35°C in the southeast by the end of the week. Temperatures today reached 27°C in London, but Sunday will be the better of the 2 days, with England seeing fine, dry weather, sunny spells, with a mercury rising above 30°C, 86°F. A sunburn warning has been issued across the UK after hundreds were hospitalised as Britain struggles to cope with a heatwave. Pictured, Weymouth Beach. People enjoy the warm weather on the beach and in the sea in Whitstable, Kent, as the hot weather continues. Pictured, the sun shone on competitors taking part in the 2018 Thames Barge Race, which started at 10 a.m. this morning in Gravesend. Crowds flocked to Weymouth Beach as the school holidays start and the heatwave on the Dorset coast continues. Others use the sunny day to collect oysters during the Whitstable Oyster Festival. Barges have to complete a return course between Gravesend and Southend-on-Sea in the competition, which began in 1863. Temperatures are set to remain in the high 20s across southern parts and could climb even higher going into the weekend. Your browser does not support the less than code greater than iframe less than code greater than HTML tag. Try viewing this in a modern browser like Chrome, Safari, Firefox or Internet Explorer 9 or later. Professor John O'Hagan, of Public Health England, told The Telegraph, "Our advice is to think about what you're doing in the sun and use some common sense. Know the limits of your own skin. Don't stay out in strong sunshine for too long. Wear wraparound sunglasses, wear a hat, cover up with light clothing, and if you need to, seek shade during the hottest parts of the day and use sunscreen that's at least factor 15. With the sunny weather showing no signs of relenting, a reservoir near Chorley, Lancashire, has become parched and cracked. Photographs capture the Yarrow Reservoir, which was built to supply Liverpool, dry and barren, showcasing only a muddy display. Children can be seen enjoying the start to their summer holidays by having a splash in the sea in Weymouth Beach and Dorset. Many of the vessels involved in the Thames Barge Race are more than 80 years old. Plenty of people enjoyed the start of the school holidays in Weymouth Beach and Dorset this weekend. The two-day festival is a celebration of Whitstable's oyster trade. Sunday will be the better of the 2 days, with England seeing fine, dry weather, sunny spells, with a mercury rising above 30°C, 86°F, pictured, Weymouth Beach in Dorset, pictured, the parched and cracked landscape at Yarrow Reservoir near Chorley, which was built to supply Liverpool. The water feature, pictured, is owned by Umited Utilities, who are introducing a hosepipe ban on the 5th of August 2018. The water feature is owned by Umited Utilities, who are introducing a hosepipe ban on the 5th of August 2018. Britons are apparently missing crucial areas, such as backs of knees, ears, and underarms, when applying sun cream, putting them at risk of cancer. Matthew Patey, CEO of BSF, said, "The rise in hospital admissions for sunburn isn't surprising as the current heatwave continues. However, it is avoidable, and by following a few simple steps people can prevent not only a visit to A&E but also the harmful long-term effects of sun exposure. The muddy gully is where the small river Yarrow should be. It normally flows through the bridge." The RAC claimed that some 9 million people could be on the roads over the weekend during the major getaway. When are the best times to travel this weekend, and what will be the worst roads for long delays? Day leisure trips by car. Worst times to travel on major roads. Best times to travel on major roads. Worst roads for long delays. Friday, 3.8 million between 2 p.m. and 5:30 p.m. between 7 p.m. and 9 p.m. M40 South J3A to J1A, 1 hour 30 minutes delay at lunchtime. M5 South J12 to J31, 1 hour 17 minutes delay late afternoon. M5 North, J31 to J12, 1 hour 9 minutes delay mid-afternoon. A303, M3 to A37. 52 minutes delay late afternoon. Saturday, 3.2 million between 11:30 a.m. and 1 p.m. between 7 a.m. and 9 a.m. M25 anti-clockwise, J23 to J16, 40 minutes delay early afternoon. M1 North, J6 to J23A, 20 minutes delay late afternoon. Sunday, 2.2 million between 12 p.m. and 1 p.m. between 7 a.m. and 9 a.m. M25 anti-clockwise, J23 to J16, 30 minute delay at lunchtime. M40 South, J3A to J1A, 20 minutes delay late afternoon. Source: The RAC. In RIX, what are the RAC's tips on avoiding or coping with traffic jams? 1. Think carefully about when you're traveling. Most traffic queues are caused by too many cars on the same roads at the same time. If you can travel outside the peak times, think early in the morning or later in the evening, you can easily miss them. 2. Make sure your car, and anything you are towing, are up to the job. Many summer breakdowns are avoidable. Punctures, for instance, can be caused by a tire that is in poor condition or just not inflated properly. And aging batteries can struggle in lots of stop-start traffic. Consider replacing it if you have any concerns. And check your air conditioning is cooling properly. If it's not, it might need regassing. An easy job for a good garage. 3. Make sure you and your passengers are as well. Hungry, thirsty or tired passengers are recipes for in-car irritability and arguments. So when setting out, pack enough food and water to keep your passengers happy, and plan in enough breaks along the way. More than a quarter of British people don't feel the need to wear sun cream at all, a new YouGov study found. 27% of respondents don't wear it and 26% stick to factor 30. Over this weekend, the southeastern parts of Wales will experience temperatures in the mid-20s, rising on Sunday, while northwest Scotland will see cloudier and wetter conditions. A couple enjoy the warm weather on the beach in Whitstable, Kent, as the hot weather continues. Man's best friend. This photograph shows a dog and his owner enjoying a splash in the sea in Weymouth Beach, Dorset. Thunderstorm warnings were in place across most of southeast England until the end of Friday, the Met Office said. Forecasters probably won't need to extend them into Saturday, although heavy rain was persisting in the southwestern Wales. Meteorologist Stephen Keats said, "We have got some heavy showers around in a line from southwest towards Dorset, Hampshire way at this point. Nothing especially disruptive." In Wales and southwest England there are some clusters of showery rain which could bring some heavy bursts very locally, probably not to the extent mentioned in the warning. Mr. Keats said, "There will still be dribs and drabs of drizzly rain in places, but the amount of rain at this stage should probably not be much. Most places will see some sunshine by the afternoon, but there still will be quite a lot of cloud in some places. It won't be wall-to-wall sunshine. As of Wednesday, the UK had just 1.85 inches, 47 millimeters, of rain, making it the driest start to summer in modern records, which date back to 1961, followed by 2013 with 2.3 inches, 59 millimeters, of rain. More than 9 million people are expected to take to the roads on leisure trips between Friday and Sunday.